Well, it's my first time in Melbourne, first time in Australia, so I didn't really know what to expect. I think I found a real positive vibe, a real good feeling. A lot of enthusiastic people, very positive, and people who really want to change the city and make it more livable by creating more solutions for cyclists. And that's very good. And I think if you compare it to Holland, it's very difficult because we started it a long time ago. But I think there's a lot of progress. And you can see it on the streets, and it makes the streets better. So I'm impressed by what I saw. The most surprising for me is that cycling in Melbourne or in Australia, I think, is much different from cycling in Holland. In Holland, we were literally born on the bikes. It's normal, completely normal for us. So we do groceries on the bike, and we go to school, we go to the sports, all kind of trips. While here in Melbourne, which I have seen, most of it is guys, a few women in Lycra, going really fast on bikes through the inner city. That's a real big difference between Holland and cycling in Melbourne is that in Holland everybody bikes, and here it's just a piece of the total population. What steps? No, there are a few steps, I think, but I think you already made a few steps, and that's something to be proud of, I think. There's always some basic facilities which you need if you want to create a cycling-friendly city. And mainly there are two. One is infrastructure. Of course, you have to work on the infrastructure, but that will go step by step. Once there are more cyclists, there will be more need for more infrastructure. You need parking solutions, and I heard a few stories already about it. People go from A to B. There has to be a parking solution where they start and where they end. But the real big thing what you need, I think, is a good plan, a good story, and make it a real story from the city, get funding, and keep on the work and the positive vibe. Use that to create a total cycling scene. To be honest, I didn't really know what to expect when I came here. I had never been in Australia, never been in Melbourne. Didn't really know what to expect on this conference. On this day and probably tomorrow also, I've seen a few things that I can take back, which are more on the behavioral side. In Holland, we don't think a lot about cycling. We just do it. It's normal. If you ask a Dutch guy what he thinks about cycling, he doesn't know what to answer because it's completely normal. But here, it's a lot of focus on the behavioral side, data collection, right to work, right to school. And I think that's where we can learn in Holland, because even though we have a lot of cyclists, we want to have more. So I think if we add those things in our policies, we can have more. So that's what I take back. Well, important is the content. I mean, it has to be a good content, because there are people, all kind of people from universities, people from consulting people from cities. But what I think is important, that presenting on a conference about biking is pretty easy, because there are already all the people are very friendly about bikes, they are very pro-bike. But I think what a conference needs is also people who are against bikes. Probably not the common visitors of bicycle conferences, but if you want to improve cycling, you want to have more people cycling, you have to fight the people who are against the bikes. And I have never seen a bike conference doing that, but we try to organize Veo City, and that was our plan. I mean, if you want to go ahead, you have to compete against your opponents. And I think that will be a challenge to do that.